I want to introduce, I know we've already introduced Mindy Fowler. She is my East Carolina University grad student, and she is going to do some of the postpartum complications.
Before we get started, does everybody have a copy of the PowerPoint?
Thank you.
You're welcome. We're looking at the case study evaluation board. Everybody has all 3 days. Again, my name's Mindy Fowler. I am an East Carolina University grad student for the Nurse in Education, Go Pirates. And I just, a little bit about my background, because I've worked with a few of you guys in clinical, but not all. I've been a nurse for 15 years. I work at Catawba Valley Medical Center. Have background in orthopedic nursing, inpatient rehab, case management, discharge planning. And I'm talking to you guys today about postpartum care. I don't have postpartum in my background, but like what Ms. Caldwell and Ms. Kiesler say, your med-surg background, your basics, will follow you throughout all of your patient population, from your pediatrics to your geriatrics. So I know a lot about my med-surg, and we're going to tie those together and tailor those med-surg topics today into postpartum complications. So first off, our objectives today, your learner, which is you guys, are going to be able to recognize the signs and symptoms of postpartum complications to your patient. You guys are going to be able to implement interventions related to the treatment of postpartum patients and to the complications that they encounter. And you're also going to be able to discuss patient education. Patient education is a big deal whenever you have patients with complications. So we're going to learn some patient education topics and be able to take care of those patients. So our first topic today is thrombosis. Like what Ms. Caldwell said, what is it? What is a thrombosis? It's a blood clot within the vascular system. It's also known as venous thromboembolism, VTE. VTE occurs in 900,000 people annually. That's a big number. And over a third of these VTE cases can lead to death. So this is a very serious thing for having these thrombosis, these blood clots. This is broken down into three different sections. SVT, which does not stand in this case for a supraventricular tachycardia for your cardiac patients. This is more for the thrombosis. This is superficial venous thrombosis. It's in the saphenous veins or the superficial veins. Also DVT, deep vein thrombosis, more in the deep veins. And that could be anywhere throughout the body in the deep veins, but mostly we focus on the ones in the bilateral lower extremities. Also, thromboflebitis, which is a clot that's formed in response to inflammation in the vein wall. How can you get a thromboflebitis? Can somebody tell me how a thromboflebitis can occur? Anybody have any ideas? Infiltration of IV site, the inflammation from the infiltration of that IV site can lead to thromboflebitis and then can lead to a blood clot. So what causes thrombosis? Particularly in the postpartum patient, it's the increasing clotting factors of fibrinogen during pregnancy and during the first 6 weeks after delivery. Also, there's other risk factors that include C-section births, endometriitis, immobility, multiparity, trauma to any extremities, varicose veins, advanced maternal age. Anybody over 35 years of age is at risk for that. History of coagulation disorders. If they've been on hormone use, they've had replacement or oral contraceptives. And then also diabetes is a big risk factor as well. So what are you going to see as a nurse? Your signs and symptoms from SVT. You're going to see localized redness, tenderness over that superficial vein. For a DVT, we traditionally see unilateral leg pain, so just in one leg traditionally, that extends up above the knee, mainly in the calf areas where you'll see that tenderness and swelling. You can also see a positive Holman sign. Does anybody know what a Holman sign is? Can someone tell me what Holman sign is?
Exactly. When
you dorsiflex and they feel that pain in that calf area, that's a positive Holman sign. Also, low-grade fever and chills can be a sign as well. diagnostic test, what are you going to see? What confirms a DVT? That is ultrasound, exactly. So we'll get the physician to order that to confirm that there is actually a blood clot there at DVT. So that goes into your nursing interventions here. What are you going to do about it? This is an emergency. You do need to call the physician immediately. You need to assess for edema, assess the peripheral pulses, temperature, color, and tenderness every 8 hours or more often if the patient is complaining of signs and symptoms. Assess the home and sign. Maintain bed rest during the acute phase. Why would we want to keep somebody at bed rest if we think they might have a blood clot? Absolutely. And how does that happen? Absolutely. When they get up, those muscles in the legs, they contract around those veins, and it brings that blood clot up to the heart, brain, or any place else like that. Absolutely. For comfort measures, you want to provide warm and moist compresses and elevate that affected limb as well. So what are we going to do about it? Treatment, medical-wise or medication-wise in the hospital, they're traditionally put on heparin IV drip. It's an anticoagulant, unfractionated heparin. It is dosed by weight-based nomogram. Labs, they check PTTs every 4 to 6 hours. And for that level of the PTT, that's when they'll adjust the dosage of the heparin IV drip.